I remember listening to a young man preach, and I remember he dropped the ASS bomb in the message, and then Dan, you know, D-A-M-N. Mm. And I was like, whoa. I was like, what is this? Mm. And I do think that there's such a rejection of rhetorical Black church preaching. Mm. I won't say rejection. People just view it in a particular way sometimes, particularly this generation. That the newer church plants and the newer leaders have so deformalized church. We've removed creeds. Mm. We don't really have liturgy anymore. Yeah. Anything that, like, liturgy, the purpose of liturgy was to catechize people's understanding of the faith,
yeah,
where every part of the gathering was helping us remain connected to the vintage faith.
Yeah.
Right? I think now, I think that people are not necessarily concerned about the vintageness of the faith. I think it's evolved. I think the whole seeker sensitive movement kind of turned the church into a me-centered disposition in preaching. Mm. And so what that's done is that has evolved the church into where it feels like I'm going to more of a comedy show, talking to a preacher, and I'm having a this type of worship experience that makes me feel this particular way. But I just feel like there's been a sacredness taken out of it because we wanted, and I think in some ways it was good, because it was good in that it removed some of the obstacles that people had with coming to church. Mm. Like, I would go on the block and say, yo, come to church Sunday. And they would be like, I need to get a suit. I need to boom, boom, boom. And I said, nah, I'm just like this. You can come. Mm. And so I think being very, very careful of letting our relatability lack honor
yeah.
And balance